unique combinations to date when it comes to brewing beer. What does coffee ale sound like to you? Yum?
I think yum, yeah. Joining us for Wet Your Whistle today, Chris Toews, General Manager for Old Chicago Pizza and Tap Room in Champaign. So we thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
And we're not only going to wet our whistles, hopefully we're going to get into some of the food stuff, but for people who haven't been to Old Chicago, tell us what we should expect.
We've been around for about 38 years. We're at specific and specialty pizzas, craft beers. We have over 30 beers on tap, 110 different beers in the restaurant. So try and get a nice variety and let you guys have some fun while you're out there.
No kidding. That's a lot of different beers. So, but the good news is you're going to find something you like.
Absolutely.
And let's actually start with some of the food. So you pair your beer with maybe a nice piece of pizza. Is pizza kind of your specialty?
Absolutely. We do two kinds of pizza. We have our Chicago Thick, which is a cornmeal, hand-tossed pizza. It's served in a pan. And then we also carry a tavern-style thin, which is a lighter, crispier texture, sliced in squares, so a little easier to eat and spread out. So
pull that up for a second. I mean, that just looks delicious. Yeah. That's like the perfect size, because some pizzas, I feel like they're too big, if you will.
Absolutely.
They're too thick.
Yeah, and we had that. I mean, obviously, with being Old Chicago, you think of a Chicago-style pizza. We do offer a version of that at our restaurant as well, but it is. It's just a ginormous, thick pizza. It gives you a nice middle ground. Still got a great thick crust, but toppings are all on top.
Yeah. What do people seem to go towards most? This type of crust?
This was our core crust to start with. The tavern got brought in about a year and a half, 2 years ago, and now we're about 50-50. I mean, it's a nice split, so.
Okay, I don't know what this is.
I
want to eat it.
Yeah, absolutely. This is our spaghetti pie. It's actually a combination spaghetti noodles with Alfredo sauce. It's all oven-baked. We top it with more Alfredo sauce, some nice mozzarella cheese, and then you get your choice of toppings, chicken, sausage. This is actually our caprese, which is fresh mozzarella, basil, and tomato.
Wow.
So, and you can choose your sauces underneath. We do marinara, Alfredo sauce. We have a carbonara sauce. So a lot of good choices and options with that.
Excellent. Ooh. So let's go back to the first part then. Let's talk about the beer.
Absolutely. That's the important part.
Yeah, well, we were talking about coffee beer. And is that a thing? Is that...
Well, what's kind of unique with this is there's always been a coffee stout. I mean, those have been kind of known and been around. Okay. What's kind of been new with ours is it's actually a coffee ale. We met with Allegro Coffee and got with Blue Nile coffee beans, which were picked by, employees and, our World Beer Tour members that have been around. And they came up with the Blue Nile coffee beans, collaborated with an ale, and it's a copper burnished colored ale, and it gave this great coffee flavor to it. So it was a little unique to us. It is exclusive at Old Chicago. We just started our Explorer series through Left Hand is our particular beer this time. So Left Hand and Allegro Coffee collaborated and made this beer exclusively for us.
That's cool. So it tastes like coffee.
It does. It does.
And
it's
beer.
It's got coffee. It's got a little bit of caramel tones. And then obviously you got your beer behind it. So it's not quite as dark as usually your stouts are. We are going to try one of the stouts from Left Hand today. This is one of the Russian Imperials. It's part of our Explorer series that we're doing. One of the new beers we brought in. So
yeah, look at the name on this. Wake Up the Dead.
Oh, yes. Yeah. And you definitely do.
With a nitro. So all right. So yeah, let's pour a little bit of this.
Absolutely.
And what's the difference between a stout and an ale?
All right, a stout is going to be a darker, more consistent. You're going to have a lot more burnt flavors. It's the roasting process. So we take and go through that. Like I said, this is going to give you a more robust flavor. Definitely a lot of, a lot of coffee, kind of burnt caramel tones behind this as well. When you go with your ales, it's going to be a lighter. You're going to have a lot more hop flavor to it. So, that's where it kind of separated out, and you put coffee with the hops, which gave it a unique flavor.
Well, I mean, I think Matt and I are both looking at this, but you have a show to host. And
you can always come out afterwards.
Well, in the meantime, we will let him swirl it around. Is that how you taste beer?
Absolutely. You smell it. I mean, it's just like you do when you sell wines. When the craft beer's coming out, it's all about the whole process. I mean, you smell it, you taste it, you let it hold in your mouth, feel all the different flavors and textures you get.
Smooth.
Yeah, it is.
And is that something that this group is known for, the Left Hand folks?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's a lot of craft beers out there. But this, I mean, they have all these different varieties nowadays, so you want to be able to try them all, and that's what we really try and do. I know I said I had 110 beers this time. We've carried over 500 beers last year.
Wow.
So different varieties, different breweries, local breweries, so we really try and get out and try a little bit of everything.
So then one other question. Yeah. Craft beers, why? Go ahead, Joe, keep drinking. Oh. I'll host.
I will.
Okay, so craft beers. Like, this is, they've been around a while, but I feel like this has become kind of mainstream.
Absolutely. I mean, you're seeing more breweries pop up, and we've had a couple breweries in the last year pop up here in Champaign-Urbana. So, I mean, it is new. But, like I said, it is definitely becoming mainstream. I think you're just seeing more collaborations. You're seeing different flavors. I mean, we got stuff like Radlers, which are kind of a cross between a wine cooler and a beer, a little more fruit-flavored, very light. You're seeing a lot of your different stouts and all those things. So, just a lot of fun that goes along with it. So, people are enjoying brewing their own stuff.
Well, I'm certainly happy that you came and joined us today. And,
after just three sips.
I may be getting into this now. I'll work up an appetite.
That's right.
We thank you so much, Chris.
Hey, thank you guys for having me. It's been a pleasure.
For sure. Hey, we're going to connect you to their craft beer menu and more online at CIliving.tv. Now, here's Heather.
All right, today's CI Giving is...